welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. Today in the workshop we're making this, turning two sphericals, some diameters. This is two pieces, a thread, internal and external, and this is a handle. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it.
Okay, I'll turn this down to 8 millimeters, face it off. Touch the tool on the end, zero my digital readout. I want to come down about 20 millimeters, just about there.
.09, that's near enough.
In the tailstock, I fitted my spring-loaded center. So that goes in the back of my tap wrench and guides the tap square into the hole. I'm just running the bottoming tap down to make sure that the hole is tapped all the way down.
Just take off the sharp edges with a file.
Just check that the tool is set square. Everything's locked up.
Now we'll start to make the second part. Take off the sharp edges with a file.
I've just put a parallel bar in the tailstock with a square end. Put my 5mm in the die stock. I'm using the bar to hold the die square. Just turn the chuck. I've gone right up to the end. Just check that it fits the other part. Just machined. I've taken my compound slide off and I'm just fitting a radius turning attachment. All it is two pieces of steel, some bearings in. This part on the bottom matches the dovetail on there, so put that in. This turns. It uses the two grub screws here. The hold down the compound slide. I use it for holding this. This just swivels. The cutting tool there, and there's a pin that goes in the middle, and the distance between the cutting tool and the pin is the radius that you're cutting. I've taken my chuck off. This is a number 3-2 Morse taper. Then I can put the Jacob's chuck in the headstock. And what that does, it gives me clearance underneath so that the radius attachment won't fail anything. Now if my chuck was here, chuck jaws would hit this. In the middle here, this slides backwards and forwards. The hole there is the centre of the bearings that are underneath. This rod will fit in that hole. I know what that diameter is, so therefore I can set my tool to that diameter. If I need bigger, I can use some gauge blocks in there to make the radius bigger. If I need it smaller, I have another peg that I can put in there, which has a flat face, and that is the centre of the radius. So I can go right up to the face, then put some gauge blocks to give me the radius I want. Now the radius I need for this is about 7mm. This setting piece is 12mm diameter, so that's 6mm. So I want this tool to come out another mil from that. So I'll put a little bit more in here. The slip gauge.
And lock that in position.
The final adjustment with the tool, because that's not tight. Oh, that's up on the end here. So now we've set that at the radius.
I've fitted the handle to this so I can turn it. It's just a rod that comes out here, which I use on my tool and cutter grinder. And I'm just bringing the tool tip in till it touches the face. And I'll start on the corner.
Move it out the chuck a little bit. I'll leave that. I've set my digital readout to zero so I can repeat the diameter exactly. Not that it's essential, it's just a handle. So take this one out, that's finished. Put the other one in. I'll rough this out first because it's on a smaller diameter. And I'm going to have trouble with this one. Once more, I need to pull this out the Jacob's chuck so that I can get right round the back. This is going to be a bit more difficult since it's only a small. So I'll go on the smaller diameter. That's about the best I can get that one. That's for 2 1420 on this end, 1435 on that end. These are the two pieces we made. This part screws inside. That's the handle finished. Now to find out what it's for, I'll finish off the next part in the next video. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.